Welcome to the ThinkCell Tutorials. This video shows you how to work with ThinkCell's text labels. When you insert a ThinkCell chart, it will appear with a certain default set of text and data labels. These labels depend on the chart type. A column chart, for example, comes with segment labels, total labels, category labels, and series labels. If you are not happy with the default labels that are displayed in a newly inserted chart, you can always add other labels or remove existing ones via ThinkCell's context menu. If, for example, you do not want series labels to be displayed in your column chart, just right-click on the chart and select the Remove Series Labels button. Let's have a closer look at the label types for different chart types. Category labels are supported for column, line, and area charts, and are represented by these buttons in ThinkCell's right-click context menu. Series labels can also be used for column, line, and area charts. Segment labels are supported in all column charts. Point labels are available for line and area charts. As well as scatter and bubble charts. Total labels can be used in column and area charts. In pie charts, there are inside labels and outside labels. Finally, the Gantt chart offers activity, item, and scale labels. ThinkCell automatically places all labels at suitable positions in your chart. If you want to manually change ThinkCell's label placement, you can use the drag icon that appears when hovering over the label. All available locations for this label will then be highlighted. Move the label with your mouse to the desired position and release the mouse button to drop the label in place. Labels without a drag icon do not offer alternative positions. If you want to rotate a label, select it and drag the rotation handle either 90 degrees clockwise or counterclockwise. Now that you know which label types are available and how labels are positioned, let's have a closer look at the label's content and format, as well as how to enter and edit it. The default content for the labels is taken from the chart's datasheet or calculated from other values. You can also type directly into ThinkCell's labels to replace their text or enter additional content. To overwrite its current content, just click on a label and start typing. If you want to keep the existing content, click on the label and use the arrow keys to enter text before or after it. Unless you delete or overwrite their data-driven content, labels are automatically updated in the chart whenever the datasheet changes, even if the label contains text that you added manually. This is particularly convenient for annotations or footnotes. However, if you delete the data-driven content and replace it with other text or numbers, the text in the label will no longer be updated from the datasheet. ThinkCell indicates this by means of a red exclamation mark that appears next to the label to alert you in case you broke the connection by accident. To reinsert the data-driven content, simply click on the exclamation mark. Now let me show you how to adjust the visual properties of a label. Just left-click on a label, or a multi-selection of labels, and ThinkCell's floating toolbar with different drop-down menus will pop up. The available options depend on the label type. The font control is available for all text labels. Click just once to open the drop-down menu, and select your preferred font from the list. The label text changes accordingly. The list of font options is defined by the settings in your Slide Master. The number format control applies to data-driven content. It offers two ways of editing the number format. You can either use the drop-down menu for quick access to the most common formats, or you can type an example figure with a desired format directly into the number format control box. The actual number you enter is not important. Only the number format matters. ThinkCell offers multiple format possibilities, like adding any prefixes or suffixes, different thousands separators, or decimal points, and options for algebraic signs. Also, you can find up to four of your most recently used custom formats in the drop-down menu. When you change the number format of one label, ThinkCell makes sure that all labels of the same type are formatted consistently. Instead of defining the format directly in the control box, you can also use a number format that has been set in Excel or the Excel-based datasheet of ThinkCell. Simply use Excel's Format Cells dialog to edit the number format as needed. Then click into the label and select Use Excel Format from ThinkCell's Number Format control. Let's move on to the magnitude control. Let's say your data sheet or Excel table is filled with 7-digit values. As it is often not convenient to have such long labels in the chart, you may prefer to display the values in millions. ThinkCell lets you do this without having to change the data source. Simply click into the label and select Units of Millions from the magnitude control in the floating toolbar. The labels are then instantly scaled to the desired magnitude. The last property control is for label content. It is available for most label types. Just click into a label and open the drop-down menu for label content. You will then see the types of automated content available for this particular label. You can, for instance, choose between displaying absolute values, or percentages, or both in the segment labels of a column chart. Simply click on your preferred option and the label content will change accordingly. Further options for other label types include showing a CAGR or the series name from your data source. Some label types only have a single entry in this drop-down menu. You can use it to restore the label's data-driven content if it was deleted. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please visit our website for more ThinkCell tutorials.